Can I have a con, please, Carol?
G.
And another one?
D.
And another?
And H.
And a vowel, please?
A.
And a vowel?
E.
And a vowel?
And E.
And a consonant?
F.
And a consonant?
L.
And a final consonant, please?
And T.
And here's that clock. Frank, what do you have?
Seven.
Seven this time. And
six.
And six, Alistair. Can you call that?
Fledge.
Fledge. And over there?
Legated.
Legated.
Yeah, I have to say, Frank, legated. Legate is not there as a verb, just as a noun, a member of the clergy. So nothing to do with legacy, I'm afraid, not there as a verb. That's bad luck.
Yeah, so fledge gets it then.
Yeah, fledge is great, actually. It's of a young bird to develop wing feathers large enough for flight. It's obviously to do with fully fledged.
Anything else from the corner?
Well, I have to let you down slowly. Deflate.
Deflate.
Yeah, deflate seven.
Very good.
All right. Well, that's tightened up the scores a little bit. Frank's got the 40 and Alistair's got 33. We're going to come to you now, Susie, and we're going to talk about origins of words, phrases.
Yes.
What today?
Well, two, I was going to ask the question, what links a bikini and a blockbuster? I have a feeling a few people will know this one. A bikini and a blockbuster.
Raquel Welch.
Raquel Welch. You're not far off, actually. Because Raquel Welch was a bombshell, wasn't she?
Yes,
and
she
in
was,
fact, the link is a bomb. And a lot of people, I think, know where bikini comes from. In 1946, the USA exploded an atom bomb in Bikini Atoll, exactly, which is a circular reef in the Western Pacific. But it's the link with bikini.
Well, I was going to say, how did that become a,
a
bikini?
Well,
bikini.
Not long after, a scanty two-piece costume for swimming in was designed, and it caused a sensation in France. And I'll read you the word first appearance in English in a Daily Courier. In 1947, and this is what it said, the French, it seems, have a new suit planned that is about twice as wide as a piece of string. It's so explosive that they call it the bikini.
Ah.
There you go. And blockbuster, which of course now means a great commercial success, in the 1940s was a huge aerial bomb that had the capacity to wipe out the whole block of streets, hence the blockbuster.
I didn't know that, did you?
No, you live and learn with Susie.
Certainly do.
Right, we're moving over to the numbers board now, and this time, Alistair, will you choose, please?
I'll have two large numbers.
Two large numbers.
And four wee ones.
A wee one. A wee four. Thank you. We have, smallest of all, number one, followed by eight and eight and ten, and then 25 and 75. With a target of 441.
And here's that clock. Alistair.
442.
Just the one away. And you, Frank?
441.
You think you have it? Okay.
Yeah, I think so.
Call out, please, Frank.
75 times 8 is 450.
75 times 8 is 600.
No, it's not. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, it's 6 times 75 is 450.
Sorry.
So, Alistair, 442.
75 minus 25 is 50.
Okay, 75, take away the 25, is 50.
10 minus 1 is 9.
Yep, 10 minus 1 is 9.
Multiply.
So 9 multiplied by 50 is 450.
Yep.
Yep.
And take away the 8.
And take away the 8. And that is 442, which is what you declared, Alistair.
7 points, levels the scores. What about that, Carol?
I said 10 plus 8 is 18. Multiplied by 25 is 450. And then I took away the other 8 and I took away the 1. So I took 9 away and that's 441.
Right. Well, the levels of scores here as we go into this tea time teaser, 40 points to each player. Here's the teaser. Lousy red, L-O-U-S-Y, lousy red, and the clue. This one is somewhat misleading. This one is somewhat misleading. The words on the card are lousy red, and the clue, this one is somewhat misleading, and the answer is delusory, delusory. Look at the scores, 40 playing 40. Oh. So a good last section in front of us. And Frank, here we go.
Can I have a consonant, please, Carol?
You can, sir. Q.
And another one.
You probably don't want that one, do you? D.
And another.
R.
And a vowel, please.
O.
And another one.
A.
And another.
And E.
And a consonant, please.
M.
And a consonant.
T.
And a vowel, please.
And a vowel, thank you. And A.
And here's the clock. Frank, what do you get there?
Just five.
Just five that time. And you?
I'm written it down, five.
You haven't written it down? Let's hear it.
Dream.
Then. Dream, yeah. And?
Trade.
Trade. Right, in the corner?
We have a seven. With a flourish of a cape, we produce Matador.
Very good.
Nice.
And am I not right in thinking that Alistair could have put a T on the end of that dream?
Dreamt, yeah. It's one of the very few words, isn't it, adjectives that end in a T.
Yeah.
Yeah, very good.
What else? Matador?
Matador. And Radome again, but Matador is our best.
Okay. Yeah. You ever been to a bullfight, Carol?
Never been, no. Not sure that I'd like to go, to be honest.
I've been to one, and you think it's going to be fun, and it then gets less and
it
less
gets
fun.
Gets less and less fun.
More and more, why are we here? And this is all rather grim.
All right. Yeah. We'll move on. We're going to look at this, a very tight game, 45 playing 45. And Alistair's going to see what he can do to break the deadlock.
Vowel, please, Carol.
A vowel. U.
Another vowel.
O.
Another vowel.
And A.
Consonant.
R.
Consonant.
W.
Consonant.
C.
Consonant.
D.
Consonant.
M.
And a vowel.
And that is E.
And here's the clock. Alistair, what do you have there?
Six.
Six this time, Frank.
And a six.
And six. Frank, we'll have your six.
Coward.
Coward, is that? Yeah, and you?
Crude.
Crude or crude?
Crude.
Crude, absolutely.
Crude.
Yes.
Okay. What have we got in the corner?
Well, we've got the easy one. I'll give you that one, and Susie give you the hard one. Comrade is my easy one. Seven.
Comrade's good seven. And the...
There's a term in billiards, to carom. If the ball hits the side of the table and bounces off, it rebounds. It's carom is the verb, and you can have caromed, the past tense. C-A-R-O-M-E-D is there for seven.
It's a sign of a misspent youth. Knowing too much about billiards, Susie. I'm worried about you now.
51, playing 51. How are we going to break this? Frank, you're going to see what you could do.
Can I have a consonant, please, Carol?
Gosh. T.
And another one.
And G.
And another.
And L.
And a vowel, please.
U.
And a vowel.
I.
And another vowel, please.
E.
And a consonant.
T.
And a consonant.
S.
And a final consonant, please.
And N.
And here's the clock.